So hello students, in this lecture we'll discuss about the very important topic, that is ambiguity problem in multiple inheritance. So you know there are different types of inheritance, but in the multiple inheritance there is a one problem. That problem we need to solve using some different method that we will need to cover in this lecture. Okay, let's see. Here we have a class A1 and class A2. Both the classes inherit by class B. Okay, so in class A1 there is a one method called the name show, and in class A2 there is one method name is show. Okay, so there is no error between these, okay, because this class is different, this class is different, and this class has some method that is show, and this class its own method that is show. Now how you can inherit these two classes in multiple inheritance? This is the syntax. Class A1 you have, class A2 you have, and class B which inherits A1 and A2 with public visibility mode. Okay, so everything whatever present in A1 and A2, everything is public to class B. Okay, that's why the class B object can easily call each method from A1 and A2. So see this code. In this code I have a class A and I have a class B. Okay, so A and B are the different classes but having the same method name, like show and show. So there is no any issue because class A is different, class B is different. But here it is a class C which inherits the class A and class B. Okay, so this is the example of multiple inheritance, and the visibility mode is public here and public here. It means this show method is public to class C and this show method is also public to class C. Okay, so the main thing is that the object of class C can easily call this show method and this show method. Okay, so let's create a one main function. In this main function I create object C of which class object? C class object. Okay, so as I already told you that object C can call show method. Okay, but here it is one confused statement, which show method will get a call. Okay, and that's why the ambiguous problem came into the picture. Now this show method from class B and this show method from class A, both are accessible to this object C, okay, which is the object of class C. Now the compiler will get confused which show method I need to call because both the classes is inherited by class C. So in this case we need to take care about something, that is whenever I want to call class A show method, you have to do some changes here. Okay, and wherever you want to call class B show method, you have to do some changes here. What type of changes you need to do, that we'll see in this slide. Okay, so here you have to explicitly mention which class or method you want to call. Okay, so here you have to take one extra efforts, that you need to use the scope resolution operator here, and you need to write object C dot A is the class name, then scope resolution operator, and then the method name, which method you want to call from class A. And for class B show method you have to write object C dot B, then scope resolution operator, show method. Okay, And now there is no ambiguity present in this code because everything is clear. This show method is from class A and this show method is from class B. So this is the solution for ambiguity problem which is present in the multiple inheritance. Okay, and now you will get the output class A and class B because you wrote here cout class A and cout class B. So guys, you need to remember these are the very small things but very important in terms of end sem examination. And if you have any doubt for within this complete inheritance topic, you can ask me in the comment section, as well as you can post your doubt in redhatcoder.com, so where we are all present to solve your doubt as soon as possible. Okay guys, so we'll see in the next lecture, and stay at home, stay safe. Thank you.